Do you know there are different date and time functions in Power BI? Hi, I am M. Asif Hussain from Know How Academe. In this video of DAX functions part 2, we will look into few of the date and time functions that are suitable in order to work on in the data set that we have. In this video, we are going to see what is date function, date diff function, day function, month function, quarter function, today function, weekday function, week number function, and year function. So let us start seeing this practically. I am taking a data set where I have a column called sales date. So in this sales date column, I would like to see all my years in a separate column. I would like to see all my months in a separate column. I would like to see all my dates in a separate column. How should we do this? So here I have to choose new column where a new calculatеd column will be added physically to the data set. So as soon as I click on new column, I have to write the column name. So let me write the column name such as year. Let us segregate year separately in a new column, but the condition here is that we should not disturb the original data set that we have received from the client. Now the data that I have here, under this I have a column called sales date column. This sales date column that I have received, it is the original column that I have, so I should not disturb the original column. Without disturbing it, I am adding a new column. And in that new column, I have to segregate my year function in a separate way. So let me write the column name such as year equal to. The DAX function in order to find out year is year itself. So once when I click on year, it is asking me the date. Where do I have my date information? I have it in sales date column under my data table. So we need to write the table name, which is data. Under this data, I have my column name called as sales date. So let me find out my sales date. Here I have my sales date column, data of sales date. Click on enter. So once when I have clicked on enter, I will get all my years separately in a new column with the name year as my column name. In the same way, we can find out month. We can even separate all the dates in a separate column. Let us look into it step by step. So we have got year that we have calculatеd just now. Now let us take another new column, and in this new column, let us find out month from my sales date column. So here I will choose a new column again. I'll click on new column. As soon as I click on new column, a new calculatеd column will be added to my data set, which can be physically seen. So here the difference between new column and new measure, a very important interview question. A new column will add a new calculatеd column to the data set, which can be physically seen. It will increase the size of the data set. And new measure, it stores the value inside the variable, but we cannot see the values physically in the data set when we use new measure. So that is the difference between new measure and new column. So this can be one of the important interview questions if you are attending the interview of Power BI. Now let me write my column name, then I will choose my function. So the column name, I am choosing it as month equal to. The DAX function in order to find out month is month itself. So month of, what is my date information? Sales date. So I need to choose my sales date column. So data of sales date, then click on enter. So once when I click on enter, I get all my months information in a separate column. All right, so we have got month information separately. Now you might have a doubt. In the original data that we have received, we have month as April, May, June, July, the name of the month clearly specified. But why do we get this number instead of April? Why did we get 4? Instead of March, why did we get a number? Instead of September, why did we get 9? So Now we can get this month information because we are calculating month with respect to the date information. Now the point is, if you want to convert this month number 4 in order to get month name, we have another type of DAX function there. We will discuss it later on in our subsequent videos. So now we have found out year, we have found out month from this particular sales date column. Let us find out the date. How should we get the date separately? So in order to do this, let me again choose a new column. We need to have one important condition to be noted. The condition is that we cannot have same columns in one particular data set. For example, if I have date column in my data set which is already existing, I cannot have my another column name as date again. So two similar column names is not allowed. We have to change the column name. I have taken already a column name called date. So in a short form, let me write DTE. Okay, date equal to, I would like to segregate date in my new column. So for this, the DAX function that we use is day. The DAX function that we use is day. So in day, again my sales date column. If I click on enter, I will get all the dates under my sales date column in a new column that I have created with the name DTE. So now, as we can see, we have got year separately, we have got month separately, we have even got the date separately, as we can see there in the sales date column. So now you might have a question. Okay, so we have found out date, we have found out year, we have found out month. I don't want in this way. I want to see my date completely. In order to find out the date, okay, we have a DAX function called as a date, where it follows year, month and date format. So let me show it to you. For example, if you would like, if you have the complete whole table with multiple columns with multiple date informations there, you would like to see some specific information. So now whenever we take the date function, this is very important. Whenever we use a date function, it gives us the value in the form of year, month, date with the time frame, with hours, minutes, seconds and milliseconds. Okay, so let us look into it. I'll go back to my report view. So here, let me take a new measure. Let me write my column name. I would like to find out date. I have to use the date function here. So let me write the column name such as my date. Okay, I'm choosing just my column name as my date equal to. So the DAX function I am choosing it here is date. Under date, as I told you, it follows year, month and day format. It returns the specified date in date and time format. We do not have time in our data set, but if we want to get the time also, we can use the function called date here. So for example, let me choose the first particular column that we have is 14th April 2017 our data set. Let us get it in the same way. So the year that I have is 2017, comma, month which is April, which is 4th month, comma, next date 14th is 14. Now I'll close the bracket, I'll click on enter. So now what will happen? I do not have time. Okay, in my data set, I don't have time. But when we use the date as our DAX function, it returns the value in the terms of year, month, date with hours, minutes, seconds and milliseconds format. As we don't have time specifically mentioned, we get zero there. So let me show it to you. I will choose a card chart in order to show this particular date that we have calculated just now. So let me click a card chart. So in this card chart, let me choose the DAX function that I have used just now, which is my date. So as you can see, 14th April 2017 hours, minutes and seconds. So it will return the date DAX function. It will return as the values in the terms of year, month, date and in the hours, minutes and seconds format. This is how we have to use the DAX function. Now you might have a question, if I want to find out today's date, how should I do it using DAX function? So let me show it to you. I am choosing again a new measure here. In this new measure, I would like to find, using this measure, I would like to see today's date. What is my today's date? So for this, let me write a new measure. For this, I would like to select, I would like to write my column name such as today's date equal to. What is the DAX function I have to choose in order to find out today's date? The DAX function in order to find out today's date is today. It is today. So today, it returns a current date. Okay. Today, we do not need to write anything under the today function. Just today as a function, if you click on enter, we can get the today's date in our Power BI. So I would like to show you using a card chart. I'll remove this my date column here and I'll show you what is our today's date. Okay, so let me take today's date here. So today's date is 6th December 2023 with hours, minutes and seconds format. Okay, so this is how we can choose and write today as our function. Now, coming back to our data set that we have. Okay, I had found out my year, I have found out my month, I have found out my date. Now, how should I find out what is my week number? And how should I find out the quarter in my data set? So for that, let us look into it. I will again go and choose a separate new column, a new calculated column in the data set, which adds a new column to the data set, which we can physically see it. So I have clicked on a new column. Let me choose my column name such as quarter equal to. In order to find out quarter from the date information that you have in the data set, we can write the DAX function as quarter again. It's just a quarter. So quarter of, where do I have my date information? I have it in sales date column, where I can choose my sales date column here. So what does quarter will do? It will return a number from 1st January to March is one quarter. Again, in the same way, from again January, February, March, 3 months, one quarter, 3 months, one quarter. So like this, we have four quarters up till October to December. So I'll choose my sales date column and I'll click on enter. So here we have got quarter. In this way, we can find out quarter from the date information that we have in our data set. As we can see, we have got quarter. So let us check it out. So the quarters that we have got, so we have 1, 2, 3, 4 quarters in the data set. Okay, now how to find out the week number? I'll choose a new column where a new calculated column will be physically added to the data set. Using this new column, I will find out my week number. In the same way, let us look into finding out the weekday as well. So what is the DAX function in order to find out week number? That we will look into it here. As I have clicked on new column, let us write our column name as I would like to find out week number. Week number equal to, the DAX function in order to find out the week number is week num itself. Week num, instead of writing the complete word number, we write num. So where do we have the date information? We have it in data of sales date column. So once when I click on enter, we get all those week numbers in a separate column. So let us see, there are how many week numbers in our data set. So once when I click on enter, we have got the week number column. So let us look into it, how many week numbers we have. So there are 53 week numbers. So there are 53 weeks in a year if we consider one separate year, you know, that we have. Okay, so this is how we got a week number. In the same way, let us find out the week day as well. So once when I clicked on a new column, we got a new calculated column in our data set. Let me write my column name such as week day equal to. In order to find out the week day, the DAX function itself is week day. Where do we have the date column? We have it in sales date. So once when I click on enter, we have got the week day in our data set. So once when I click on enter, then I have got my week day. So we have 7 days. So this is how we can find out weekday, week number, quarter, year, month, date, today, date function and all those. Now, I have another data set here where I have two different dates. Okay, I have order date and I have ship date also. So now let us find out what is the difference between these two dates. How many days difference we have in these two dates? For example, 28th August 2017 to 4th September 2017, 3rd December 2018 to 9th December 2018, 11th July 2019 to 18th July 2019. There are many dates that are specified here in order date and shift date. What is the difference? How many days difference we have? Or how many months difference we have? Or how many years difference we have? How should we find it out? So this can be found out using a DAX function called DATEDIFF. Diff is nothing but difference between two dates. So let me take a new column here. In this new column, I will write the DATEDIFF function. So once when I click on new column, a new calculated column will be added in a data set which we can physically see. So once when I clicked on a new column, I have got a column. Now let me write a column name. So column name I will write as date. Instead of date, I would like DTE, date difference. Date difference equal to, here the DAX function I choose is date diff in order to find out the difference between two different dates. So what is the date one? Date one, let me choose my order date, comma. And what is my date two, which I have it as shipment date. So I will choose as ship date, comma. What is the interval? What difference you would like to see? Would we like to see the days as a difference? Would we like to see months as a difference? Would we like to see year as a difference or hour as a difference? What interval we would like to choose, we can choose it. So I would like to see difference between 2 days, how many days difference we have. So I'll choose the interval called day and I click on enter. So once when I click on enter, I get the difference between two dates in a separate column. So if we see, we have got the difference here. The first difference is 7. So let us find out, is this correct or not? Okay. So 28th August 2017 to 4th September 2017. So 29th August, 30th August, 31st August, 1st September, 2nd September, 3rd September and 4th September. There is 7 days difference. Okay, so in the same way, we can find the difference between months, we can find the difference between quarters, we can find the difference between years and so on. This is how we can use DATEDIFF function. In this video, we have seen different date and time functions. There are still many more different date and time functions that you can practice based upon the requirements and data sets that you have. Thank you for choosing Know How Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to reach out. It's been a pleasure interacting with you. Stay curious and keep learning.